What is it with Infusoria and me? I'm starting to think I must have been an Infusorian in a previous life. What else would explain my ongoing obsession with tiny cooties that grow in stinky water? This is my third video on how to culture Infusoria. If you watched the first two videos, and if you didn't, don't bother, you know that I've had a complicated relationship with these critters and decidedly mixed success. But I'd learned so much from the comments and helpful suggestions that were added to those videos. Nevertheless, I gave up on Infusoria. For me, the time it took to culture and the unpredictability of the outcome made it a risky choice for feeding fry, especially when fry have a way of showing up when I least expect them. For my last two breeding projects, I simply went with several types of powdered fry food, and it worked fine. So why am I making a third video on how to culture Infusoria? It's because I finally stumbled across a method that's easy, quick, and reliable. I must give all the credit to Nick from Keeping Fish Simple. There's a link to his video in the description where he explains his two favorite methods for culturing Infusoria. He also offered some interesting reasons why some cultures fail. Even though I've got no newborn fry at the moment, I just had to give it a try. I started with a 2-liter glass jar with a wide mouth. I added 1/4 teaspoon of dry yeast and a bit of brown water squeezed from a sponge filter. Then I added 1 liter of aquarium water saved from a water change. That's it. I covered it loosely and placed the jar in front of a lamp for warmth. Nick said that he gets a usable culture within 36 to 48 hours. That's amazing. I didn't check mine at 48 hours because the water was still cloudy and I was too lazy to set up the microscope, fearing I'd be disappointed. But I did check after 3 days, and even though the water was still cloudy, there were faint streamers visible with bright light, and lots of cooties visible under the microscope. One day later, there were even more. There was some odor, but it wasn't the vile stench that developed with my previous cultures. Compare this outcome with my first attempt that took 6 weeks to reach a productive stage. That's one reason why I'd pretty much given up on culturing Infusoria. When it took weeks or more to get a usable product, it seemed unlikely to have a culture ready when the newborn fry appeared, unless I kept a culture going continuously. I'm thrilled with this approach and so grateful to Nick for sharing it on his channel. It's finally made Infusoria a viable option as a first food for my fry. Hopefully it's helpful for some of my viewers, and this will be the last time I bug you on the topic of how to culture Infusoria. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.